nature has always been the most important thing in my life. Earning money, making a living, designing things has always been on the fake side. Nature on the other side can't be faked. It's always there. It's always has been there. No matter what I do, no matter what I design or produce, the importance of nature in my life is the balance of being real and just making a living. It has a very important place in my life. I need being alone, being with myself, and just be trying to clear my mind. The bicycle in itself is almost perfect, no matter what kind of bike it is. It's probably the best escape vehicle that's ever been invented, that enables people to get from A to B, you know, from stressful environment that they live in, to come to places like this in a very short amount of time. I just feel very at home in nature. I'm not anxious when I'm here, I'm just in complete peace. Sleep here under the stars. It's just that perfect cutoff. So when I go down to work the day after, I'm just well rested. You know, I'm a better person if I can go into nature and stay the night, no doubt. If I were to design bikes the way that I want to have bikes, they would be super Scandinavian, because I'm Scandinavian and I have this sort of heritage of form will follow function and toned down aesthetics, and that's how I was schooled. It's a very pure aesthetic and very easy for me. So I was told that creative freedom would be a big part of the Red Hook crit design process. I felt like this is a great opportunity not to be myself and not to be held back by my heritage or by the corporate identity, but do something that's really crazy. When Milano came up as a city, there's a great heritage of design in Milano. To me, there's one guy that really is the guy. When I think of Milano, I think of Ettore Sottsass and I think of the Memphis group. You look at the stuff that came out of this guy's mind, and half of the time you get super confused. It's like, what the fuck is that? The whole purpose of starting the Memphis group and getting designers together in Milan in the early 80s was to tear down all the boundaries and all the walls of what art was and what design and architecture was. Looking at the essence of what they did is so close to what punk rock is and what like black metal is. I see Ettore Sottsass as a punk rock designer. Making a marble front wheel doesn't make any sense. Or making a plywood rear wheel doesn't make any sense at all. So I've been trying to take the essence of his legacy, of his work, and applying that into a manufactured object. Putting chaos and the organized aspects of what industrial design is and applying that to a project. You know, this is a tribute to one of my idols, and it's not a copy-paste exercise, because that would have been too easy, you know. What was the question again?